हेलो चिल्ड्रन, यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस सम क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 10.1। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट अनदर क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर गिवन इन दिस एक्सरसाइज, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 एंड 13। ओके, सो सी हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 इज अमंग टू सप्लीमेंट्री एंगल्स द मेजर ऑफ द लॉन्गर एंगल इज 44 डिग्री मोर दैन द मेजर ऑफ ए स्मॉलर एंगल, find their measures. Okay, so first of all we know that two angles are supplementary if the combination, if the sum of both angles are 180 degree. So let us assume that a smaller angle is equals to x. Okay, I am assuming that smaller angle is x degree. Now it is given the measure of longer angle is 44 degree more than smaller angle. So if I have a smaller angle, that is at x, then larger angle will be, it is given 44 degree more than smaller. So it will be x, we will add 44 in it. Okay, so smaller angle we have assumed that it is x and the larger angle is x plus 44. Now we know that x plus 44 means if we add both the angles the value will be equals to 180 degree. Now solve this, x plus x, that will be 2x plus 44, that will be equals to 180 degree. Now 44 will go on this side, that will give you 180 minus 44, or value of x will be 180 minus 44 upon 2. Okay, so it will be 136 upon 2 means 68 degree. Okay, that means the smaller angle is what? 68 degree. Okay, so answer will be smaller angle is equals to 68 degree. Larger angle will be equals to how much? We have to add 44 in it. Okay, so that will give you 112 degree. Okay, so this is your question number 8. I think it is clear to you how we have done this. Okay, now similar case is there in question number 9. If an angle is half of its complement, okay, find the measure of angle. Similarly, okay, we will let one angle is equals to x. Okay, then another angle will be what? Okay, it is given now. An angle is half of its complement. Okay, means this angle will be half of this angle. Okay, that is x by 2. And the addition of both will be equals to how much? That is 90 degree because it is complement. Now, solve this. We will take LCM. It will give you 2x plus x equals to 90 degree. That will be equals to 3x. 2 will be gone. At this side, that will be equals to x equals to 90 into 2 by 3. Okay. So, it will be 60 degree. Okay. So, one angle is 60 degree. Then, first angle. For a question, first angle is 60 degree and second angle is what? It is half of this angle, that is 60 by 2, that means 30 degree. Okay, so this is your question number 9. Okay, I think both the questions are now clear to you. Okay, solve like this only. Now, see here, next one. Two adjacent angles are in the ratio 5:3 and they together form an angle of 128 degree. Find these angles. Okay, So adjacent angles means what? Just side by side angle. Okay. If I say that two angles are adjacent, if vertices of both angles are same. Okay. That means x and y are adjacent with each other. So see here, if this angle is z. Okay. So what it will be? It means x plus y should be equals to z. Okay, so that is given in your question also. It is given two adjacent angles are in the ratio 5 is to 3. Means this angle is, first angle is 5x and second angle is 3x. I have told you if you have to write the angle from the ratio, then what you will do? You will multiply both with a variable. Okay, same variable. So this is your value. And 5x plus 3x will be equals to what? See, it is given. They together form 128 degree. So, addition of both will be equals to 128 degree. Okay. So, now solve this. It will be 8x equals to 128. So, okay. So, this will be your value of x, and if you have find the value of x, then you can find the value of both the angles. Okay, it will be 60. So angles are 5 into 16 and 3 into 16. Okay, solve this and you will get the values of both the angles. Okay, I think now it is clear to you. Now see question number 11, 12 and 13. Some of the parts I am giving to you. Okay, and rest of the part you will do by your own. Now see here in this question. See, all are, this is the angle at a point. So I have told you angle at a point means the sum of all the angles should be equals to 360 degree. Okay, that means 41 plus 105 plus x plus 130 will be equals to 360 degree. Okay. Now you can solve this expression and you can find the value of x. How? X will be equals to 360 degree minus, all will be gone here, that is 41 plus 105 plus 130. First of all, add all and then take it to the left next side. That will give you the value of x. Clear? Now see here in this case, see, this is your straight line. Okay, and on the straight line, on one half, on one part, means on one side, the total sum of all angles should be equals to 180 degree. That means 3x plus x plus 40, that will be equals to 180 degree. And okay, 3x plus x plus 40 will be equals to 180 degree. Now solve this, it will be 4x equals to 180 minus 40, that is 140. So x will be equals to 140 by 4. That will be your answer. Okay. 4 3 is a 12, 4 2 is a 32 degree. That means the value of x is 32 degree. Then the value of 3x will be, multiply it with x. Means in all case you have to find the value of x only. So this will be your answer. Okay, in this case solve this, you, that will give you the answer. Similarly in this case, all angles, sum of all angles should be equals to 180 degree. So see here, I am doing here, it is 2x plus 10 degree plus 3x minus 10 degree plus 40 should be equals to 180 degree. Now solve this. 2x plus 3x, it will be 5x. Now see it, plus 10 minus 10, both will be cancelled out. and this 40 will be gone here. 180 minus 40, that will be equals to 40. So x will be equals to 140 by 5. So x will be equals to 28 degree. Clear? So all questions are clear to you. Now see here, in this case what you will do, first of all see this, all you have to find the value of x, y and z. So first of all we will find the value of z. Why? See, this is your straight line. On first, on one side the addition of both angle will be equals to 180 degree. Okay, that means z plus 135, that is equals to 180 degree. So z will be equals to 180 minus 135. There you will find the value of z. Okay, now see here, this is also your straight line. Okay, so by this straight line x plus 135, that will be equals to 180 degree. Okay, see in your figure only, I am giving you hint in this figure. See, this total angle is equals to 180 degree. That means x plus 135. So you can find the value of x, that is 180 minus 135. Okay, now see this. This total angle is also equals to 180 degree. Okay, so 180 degree. 180 degree will be equals to z plus 135. So z will be equals to 180 minus 135. Clear? Now 180 minus 35. Now from this you have got the value of x, and if you have got the value of x, then you can find the value of y also. How? 180 minus x, that will give you the value of y. So this is the way you have to do this question. Now next one, see this. Okay, this is your straight line. Okay, and one angle is given, that is 90 degree. This sign means it is 90 degree, and one angle is given, that is 31. So if you have to find the value of y, what you will do? 31 plus y plus 90, that will be equals to 180 degree. Okay, so now you can find the value of y. Okay, y will be equals to y plus 121 equals to 180. So y will be equals to 180 minus 121. And if you have find the value of y, so by this see here, y and z, okay, both are vertically opposite angles. Okay, y and z are vertically opposite. In this case also, if you have find the value of z, you can find the value of x by vertically opposite angles. Okay, both will be equal, x and z will be equal. And what about y? Y will be equals to 135. That is also the case. Okay, see, solve by this only. See, vertically opposite angles are there now. So it is 135 y. Okay, so if you have find the value of z by this, then that value will be also equals to x. In this case also, okay, this is 90, so this will be also 90. Okay, now this x will be equals to how much? 31 degree, because both are vertically opposite angles. Okay, now if you have find the value of y with the help of this equation, so that will be the value of z also, because both are vertically opposite angles. So I think it is clear to you. Y and z will be equal. Okay, y will be equals to z and x will be equals to 31 degree. Clear? Now see here, in this question also, x will be what equals to? That will be 44 degree. Okay, now z will be equals to what? That is 51 degree. Okay, now two angles are given, that is 44 plus y plus 51, that will be equals to 180 degree. Now solving this, you will get 95 plus y will be equals to 180 degree. That means y equals to 180 minus 95. So that is your answer. Okay, means you have to use vertically opposite angles in this question for solving the values. Okay. Now, see question number 13 is your homework. Try to solve it by your own because it is very easy. It is given EFA is equals to AFD. That means EFA. Okay. And AFD. Both angles are equal. If it is X, it will be X. So, see here. Both are vertically opposite angles. So, that is equals to 50 degree. And if it is 50 degree, that will be also equals to 50 degree. So, you have to find the value of angle EFC. So, what is angle EFC? This angle. Okay. Now, 50 and 50 are given. You have to find the value of this angle. So, I think it is clear to you how you will do this. Okay. So, that was your exercise 10.1. It is very easy. Main thing is the concept. If the concept is clear to you, then you can solve any of the questions. Okay. So, next exercise we will discuss next lecture. Till then, thank you.